With the peace of the Galactic Republic under threat from Count Dooku, the Galactic Republic proposes a military creation act, which would authorize the creation of a Grand Army of the Republic. In a bid to maintain the peace, Senator Padme Amidala returned to Coruscant, but despite the heavy protection, Padme's starship exploded, killing several members of her guard. The assassination attempt allowed Palpatine to try and draw Padme away from the voting, as he was quietly in favour of the creation of the army, and initially, it is both Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker assigned to protect the senator. Having failed in her first attempt, Zam Vessell received poisonous arthropods to try and kill the senator in her sleep, but the Jedi performed their duty and prevent her death, then chased the bounty hunter. The Jedi pursue Vessell through the streets and skies of Coruscant, ultimately being able to question her, but before she could reveal her superior, she is killed by a saberdart. Obi-Wan is deployed by the Jedi Council to investigate the killing of the bounty hunter, as Anakin is assigned to escort and protect Padme on her return to Naboo. But what if Anakin had been tasked with going to Kamino instead of Obi-Wan? Could he save his mother? Would Anakin and Padme still be married? As you're going to discover, the Jedi Council's change of roles could have altered the fates of both good and evil. As both Anakin and Obi-Wan stood in the center of the Council chamber, Yoda and Mace Windu decided that Anakin should try and track the assassin, leaving Obi-Wan to escort Padme to Naboo. Anakin is visibly disgusted as he leaves the council members, and he headed to the Chancellor's office, before looking into the saberdart. Palpatine knew that Anakin had wanted to join Padme on Naboo, but his primary objective was to ensure the Military Creation Act passed through the Senate, and assured Anakin that the representative Jar Jar Binks would make the correct decision, and Obi-Wan would keep Padme safe. Upon hearing that the Gungan would be taking Padme's place, Anakin is concerned as he left the office, and asks Mace Windu to try and keep Jar Jar in line with Padme's plans for retaining the peace. The Master of the Order reluctantly agreed, and on the advice of his master, Anakin met with the Basilisk Dexter to identify the saberdart. The Jedi is then made aware of the plans of Kamino, and rather than going to the Jedi archives, Anakin asked his mentor Palpatine. The Chancellor provides the exact coordinates for the planet erased from the archives, as he wanted the Jedi Order to be impressed enough by the clones to trust them in battle, and Anakin flew to the planet south of the Rishi Maze. Back on Naboo, Padme had been equally annoyed by the lack of Anakin's presence, but this proved to be a blessing, as the absence of the distraction enabled her to secretly help Jar Jar through the Senate debates. Palpatine's initial frustration at the Army Act not being passed is heightened by Jar Jar's reluctance to grant him emergency powers, and he decided he could gain them later, so ordered Dooku to begin preparing their droid armies. But there was to be a slight issue in his plan, as Anakin had just arrived on Kamino when he collapsed to the floor. Visions of his mother suffering on Tatooine infected his mind, and even if he was disobeying the Jedi Council, Anakin chose to make the short trip to Tatooine. Driven by his anger, Anakin found his old slaver Watto, and he directed him to the last home, where the fate of his mother is revealed. But due to Anakin's speed of arrival, the Jedi manages to find his way to the Tusken Raider camp, and although she had been gravely injured, Shmi had managed to survive. Although Anakin wanted for Shmi to return to Coruscant, Anakin had already disobeyed the council, and did not wish to incur their wrath, then took C-3PO back to Kamino. But as he left the planet, Anakin found himself surrounded by Nantex class starfighters. Anakin used his superior skill to defeat them, then alerted the council of the attack after returning to Kamino. Waiting for Anakin to find out more about the clone army, the Jedi discovers that Master Sifo Dyas had commissioned the clones a decade ago, even though he had allegedly been killed over Felucia. Now armed with this knowledge, Anakin sought the advice of his master on Naboo, and he summoned Yoda to investigate the activity on Geonosis. The Grand Master entered into his starship, and approaching the planet, he is met by a blockade of droid control ships, clearly designed to threaten the Republic. Before he made a move to enter Geonosis, the Jedi orders Obi-Wan to take Padme back to Coruscant, as Jar Jar's resistance has started to falter. Emerging in her Senate pod for the first time since her assassination attempt, the presence of Padme is met by rapturous applause, and she is quick to state that the Jedi needed their support to maintain the peace, and offered a compromise to the other senators. If the Grand Army had to be created, the Jedi would take control, and the murmurs of approval are anger to Palpatine. The Sith Lord is forced to accept the decision, and ordered Dooku to deploy his droids on the clones heading to Geonosis. The Jedi use their combined might to oppose the threat, and gain control over the airspace, but as they descend to the ground, a much more substantial army have been waiting for them. The clones are tested to their limit and reign victorious, but a new war had started, even if not solely on Palpatine's terms. That is it for part 1 of What If Anakin Went to Kamino Instead of Obi-Wan. If you'd like to see a part 2 soon, please like this video, turn on the notification bell, click that subscribe button on this channel, as well as on my other channel What If Films. And as always, leave a comment on what if you'd all like to see next, and how I can improve my videos. Thank you all very much for watching, and see you next time.